Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Mass Effect. Episode 4 of Mass Effect. Now it is our quest to find.
Corbin, I wasn't.
Who's that?
He pays you to look at the keepers. Mm. And gives you experience too, so.
That's cool.
But I'm going.
I'll talk to you later.
So long.
So long.
Those types of missions are probably best not to live.
Yeah,
the viewers watch.
Well, we'll do it
on the side.
Unless it's a very interesting and like active mission.
It's more of go find things.
Yeah, no, all those missions we'll do on the side. We don't need to do that.
Yeah.
Anyways, what is that? Right, we are on the mission to hunt and find. Well, not hunt really, but find. What do you call a hunt?
We're on the hunt
for Garrus. That Garrus booty.
Garrus Vakarian.
Garrus Vakarian. I like that last name. And first name. Good name.
Well, they're kind of like a mix of, like, Roman Praetorians and Samurai.
Yeah, you told me.
Yeah.
Although I don't really see the.
And they kind of have, like, a Shinto type religion. Spirits and such.
Oh. I never really even heard the religion of the Turians, but is it something in the first one?
No. It has no precedence in any of the games.
Alright, then yeah, I would have no idea. They're not one of the best operatives. Isn't he known for a bunch of collateral damage?
Yeah.
How is he one of your best?
Because he always gets the job done.
Doesn't Neelis get the job done?
I don't know. He doesn't have a track record that you can actually listen to. But
there's nothing about Neelis?
Not really.
I thought it was cool. Because he was like, listen, you're cool. I'll give you a chance. You are the representative of humankind. Don't betray me. You like help out. And he's like, all right, you're cool. Just do this and this. I'm going to head for this. And then he dies. And you're like, no! Yeah.
With Saren, the counselor's just like, go take care of this. And he destroys everything.
Yeah, he killed a bunch of people. How is that good? On ours.
Hannah's, the jellyfish peoples.
Garrus is cool. The Krogan, I think Rex, he was cool, but I can't believe, like, so many people want to kill him. So many people.
Rex?
Yeah.
I was it Rex? Never killed him.
No, I didn't kill him. I said so many people want to kill him in the game.
Yeah, that's why I always get his family armor, just so he can never die.
No, I mean, in like,
in
the fucking
cutscenes.
In light
of a recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization
insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. It's like, listen, give the guy a chance.
When I first played, there was
many
nothing
colonial
I could
proposals
done.
Are
no?
on hold
what?
Until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
There's two options, either kill him or free him. You must have picked the wrong options, dude.
Well, I just played the game. I didn't do much side quests or anything.
I didn't know side quests ever. And I can say I saved them. So I think you just fucked up the option wheel.
Yeah, sorry.
But I remember at one point, like, when he was getting really excited, there was the, like, almost every time the renegade part, it was like, shoot him, shoot him, shoot him. I was like, no, man, no.
Well, the renegade thing is, like, if anybody backtalks you, you kill their ass.
Pretty much. I don't get why so many people pick Renegade, because I feel like Renegade's a douchebag of the galaxy.
It kind of has the better of, like, cut things.
I feel like some parts is better against people you hate.
Yeah.
But against people you
not
don't hate, it's, like, the worst option.
It's worth mentioning lately. Maybe
you know, I remember, it's funny, though. I remember,
maybe you've just got
for Mass Effect 2, I only played a few hours into it, and I got bored. But when I used to have the demo for the Xbox, I played the demo over, like, 6 times. Which, the demo is that beginning part where the Normandy explodes, and that mission right after it, and then that's it. I replayed the head with every class, and I was like, this is cool, I want Mass Effect 2. So I went out and buy Mass Effect 2, and I played a little bit of it, then I let my friend Corey borrow it, and I never got it back. And he's still borrowing it. But then I played 1, you let me borrow 1, and I was like, oh, dude, it's so good. So I was like, oh, I'm excited for 2, and I got bored as shit.
Well, I'm guessing that, because you've explained it before, but one of the things that you don't really like to do in RPGs is talk to every single NPC.
No. Only the ones I care about.
One of the things that you kind of need to do in Mass Effect.
Not this one. I only talked to people I thought were
now
cool.
Now for the gunfight.
After the Wheel of Death.
Spin, spin, spin. Spin to win.
Go, go, the spin will go. Where it lands, nobody knows.
That's her.
Assassin! Oh yeah, the pistol skill. The best skill. Whoa, what is this? Book? Actually, a little bit. Oh, right, the awesome thing about the first one, there's no ammo. It's game.
Yeah, game-wise, it's different. But when you're actually talking about how the game really is, it isn't. The ammo you have for these weapons is like a few thousand. So, yeah, kind of.
Well, outside of the master class ability for the pistol, I don't use even close to 100 rounds every fight.
Back
off, Rex. Fist told us to take you down.
Rex.
What are you
waiting for?
I'm standing right
here. His backstory is amazing.
I always thought Rex was cool, but I didn't use him in my team that much, just because like everyone was using him, so I was like, maybe I should try it.
The story is just beginning.
His dad tried to assassinate him, and then
what's in the scars? Explain that to me.
He was fighting a war creature.
What was that all about?
Who knows? Just try not to get caught in the middle.
Krogan worms aren't anything.
Krogan worms are like the fucking worms from
Cromnex. Cromrex.
You don't even know what Cromrex looks like. You can't even fucking say
it. I fought the son of Cromrex, thank you very much.
You mean the offspawn child baby thing that's like huge and tall?
Have a drink. See where this goes.
Yeah, it goes with me stabbing you in the fucking face.
Maybe later.
Oh.
Suit yourself, princess. You know, if more Marines looked like you, I might have joined the Alliance instead of seasick.
Shut the fuck up.
Harkin, right? I was told you could help me find someone.
Where are you looking at, Shepard? She was just like staring off at the corner.
Garrus.
He's so ugly.
One
she can't
Captain
look
Anderson's
at. Let me look at that face.
It's kind of haunting.
I know where Garrus is. You gotta
Garrus
tell
is
me
cool.
Something first.
I thought he died in the second one. I was like, no.
Is there something I should know about the captain?
When I thought he died, dude.
Captain
like,
used to be a spec.
By the way, what happens to Rex? Because you don't use Rex in the second
all
one.
Very
he,
Grunt. He becomes the leader
the
of all the Krogans.
Human ever given that honor.
What?
Yeah.
Oh.
Screwed up his mission.
He uses
so
the pull of just saving the
of course,
Citadel as being
Saren,
the primary warrior
the
thing.
Set him up.
And be like, what did you do? Oh, I saved the universe.
Why'd they kick him out?
What did you do?
I have to ask him. I never.
So I think our team should be for this one, Garrus and Rex.
Story though.
Yeah, that's
not heroes good. Fall. Classic
or you think we
tragedy.
Should change somebody out?
You said they covered all this up. How'd you hear about it?
I spent 20 years working cases here on
the
Citadel.
Oh my God.
People on this station love to talk.
Remember, we're Paragon.
Secrets are like herpes. Have you got?
You're a pig.
Just
now, did you?
Just tell me where Garrus
was. Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office.
I'm out
of
here.
What, wasn't she weird? I can't remember.
Good.
Yes,
go.
She talks very weird.
I don't remember what's weird about her. Ooh. But I remember she's very weird.
Oh, well, actually. I'll give the audience a little view.
No, just go.
No.
Go.
But there's hookers here.
I don't care.
Watch.
Go. If we're going to show them any brothel, it'll be the brothel in Dragon Age 1. Random! For those of you who don't know who've never played Dragon Age Origins, which by the way, you guys really should. It's an amazing game. Amazing. It's a medieval Mass Effect 1.
Pretty much. Which actually, they did a good thing about it. They actually converted some of the armors from Mass Effect over and some of the Dragon Age armors over. So it's pretty cool.
Which is pretty awesome. The funny thing is, if you have, speaking of which, if you have a Mass Effect 2 save file, on your system and you play Kingdoms of Amalur, you get special armor and daggers.
Yeah.
You get the Omniblade dagger things and it's like, oh!
They're amazing, especially when you begin the game.
Oh, when you start the game out,
it's
like...
a god mode.
Until you can make your own custom weapons, then nothing
yeah.
as good as that.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if you make your own custom weapon... Oh, Emily Wong, she sounds familiar.
Oh, there's actually a funny little talk scene here.
Who? We're just observing the scenic.
Between you and your crew.
And then Garrus Vakarian arrives.
Kaden actually starts flirting with you.
Shut the fuck up, Kaden.
Babe, place.
I don't think we've been listening to a dialogue enough. Let's
Is that
listen.
Your professional opinion, sir?
Is she being sassy?
Yes. He's right.
This isn't a station, it's a city.
There must be millions here. It can't be possible to track
Is he trying to slide on closer?
Going?
No, he's
this
like
makes jump
on the
zero
railing.
Look like
yeah, but
kind of
it seemed like he was like.
And it's the largest deep space station the Alliance has.
Actually, he's in between us, so.
Jump zero was.
Yeah.
But
I know, but I can see him punking her off the edge. How do they keep all that mass from
flying apart? The council represents more races than I thought. No wonder they're careful with newcomers.
I just want to keep everything.
It has to be hard keeping all these cultures working together. Oh, Volus is the round pulley guys. Like, that's what the name of them are.
I don't remember them. I remember what
they're kind of the ones that live in a methane-only environment. According and they kind of go... Vids, we
have everything they want. Oh, okay, I know them. They're not really world pulleys, but I know you're talking like about.
I mean, us. Humans. Ma'am.
You don't take much shore leave, do you, LT?
Oh!
Alright, laugh it up, Chief. I appreciate the thought, Alenka, but we're on duty here.
Aye, ma'am.
Yo, Caden. Calm your dick. Drag, ma'am. What? Actually, no.
It's actually more hilarious if you're the male shepherd. If you want me to be in silver skirt and go-go boots, just say the word, sir.
Yo, Caden is desperate for any kind of a boontang. Oh, wheel of death.
Especially if it's the male shepherd bootay.
No, that's weird. It's weird.
I didn't tell anyone, I swear.
Stay smart. Keep your mouth shut. Double O Garrus.
Who are you?
Let her go.
I'm here for medicine.
Garrus is so cool.
He's so suave with his pistol.
But damn, he gets fucked up in the second one.
Take cover!
Take him down! I think Garrus is the best. You know, I think if I actually get around to playing on Mass Effect 3, I'll play co-op with you. Gotta get down to it. Hey, go Garrus! What's up?
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
What were you thinking? You could have hit the hostage.
No, I just reacted.
I didn't mean to.
Paragon points, dude. Paragon points. We need the paragon points.
Thanks to you. All
we can protect you.
I know those men threatened you, but if you tell us who they work for,
Garrus is cool. I think my favorite male character would be Garrus.
They favorite female. Shut me up. Keep me from telling Garrus about the Quarian.
They're cool, but they're weird.
What Quarian?
But my favorite male would be Garrus. My favorite female would be Miranda.
She'd been shot.
I know what you're thinking, wouldn't tell me who did. It's purely physical.
I could tell she was scared, probably on the run.
Her sex scene where she still has her bra on.
The shadow broker. She wanted to better trade information.
Freaking. Right in the moat open area where anybody from their room could look down and go, "What's up?"
So, hey, yo, Shepard, I'm gonna get Gatorade from your fridge.
He's an agent for the shadow.
Right, a Gatorade. Pops with Gatorade. So they're still making out. Shadow
broker. They're just having sex right there in front of the engine room. I want to see one of the engineers like come by, punt them off the railing, just so that they can fix the engine.
That Quarian must have something Saren wants.
But, something worth crossing the ship. No, it's not as bad as the,
She must have.
Well, it's not really a sex scene, because sex doesn't go the on. She must be able but to more like Saren to the relationship game. Scene, I guess.
There's no way.
Time we paid the one in, visit.
Oh, whoa.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
Oh, still going. Alright, perfect. The one between, Morgan and a dwarf in Dragon Age 1. This beautiful female witch having sex with an unshaved bear.
What about Zoran and, a male dwarf?
Yeah,
that's even more ridiculous.
It's insane.
We can use him!
Morgan might come in handy.
What's he doing there?
Okay, skip all the good dialogue.
What? Alright. Caden! I mean, Varys. No, not Caden. Caden, get out of here. Yeah, I guess.
Go beat off in your little room.
Who would be better to have, Ashley or Caden?
In a Mass Effect 1, you need a lot of deception, whatever that thing is to unlock.
Combat one?
No.
Encryption?
Yeah.
So don't you need Caden since he has like a million
encryption? On missions, but as I'm just running around, I'd pick whoever the fuck I want.
Yeah, no. But since you know best, try to either, until we get everybody, just pick Garrus and whoever it would be best to have. I think Garrus and Caden are the only ones with decryption right now.
Oh, actually. There's a shortcut to this.
Sup, Garrus Vakarian!
The police area.
Yeah, isn't he a police right now, though?
Yeah, he's kind of like a detective.
Yeah. Oh no, Wheel of Death!
Load that bitch!
Load, bitch! Get out the way! Alright, that'll be it for this episode. See you guys next time. Peace!